But the dress rehearsal was not without controversy. Children running onto the circuit led to the practice session being cut short because of the danger of a serious accident. Steve Lee reports.
6:45 a.m. on a Sunday morning, and while most of the city slept, the motor racing fraternity buzzed into action. After much ballyhoo, years of argument, even an act of parliament, the city's 2.5-mile race circuit was about to be tested for the first time. The dress rehearsal wasn't just for drivers and officials. The police and emergency services wanted to test road closures and diversionary routes. There's just a month to go until the Birmingham Superprix, and much still has to be learnt about the course, which has cost £1.5 million to convert. By 7:20, a police observation aircraft hovered over the inner city, and the marshals declared the route ready. For the crowds who'd forsaken their breakfasts, it was a sight worth seeing as the cars lapped the circuit at an average speed approaching 100 miles an hour. On the straight stretches, Formula 3000 cars should be capable of nearly 170 miles an hour. But those organising the dress rehearsal stressed that this was not a race. Even so, the flavour of a Monaco-style event was enough to whet the appetite for August. Of practice came to a somewhat abrupt end. Nothing to do with the course, but pedestrians with something of a death wish strayed onto the circuit. With many of the safety fences still not up, the organisers decided to bring things to a halt.
Today was never going to be 100% secure in that sense, and we brought the session to a halt slightly early because of children running across the circuit. But we achieved what we set out to do, and I'm sure the information that I'm going to be getting is what we need to make sure that in a month's time everything is right.
There was always this danger that members of the public, be they young or old, might wander onto the circuit, and the arrangements with the British Racing and Sports Car Club was for instant stoppage if that became a problem.
Today I found that the circuit was a real driver's challenge, and that's what I like. I like driving on street circuits as well, and this one is going to count for precision, and that's what this sport's about.
Most interested parties declared themselves happy with the circuit, but doubts will still persist over one or two corners. There's also the rather more serious question of security, particularly the problem of people straying onto the course. All concerned were confident that this wouldn't happen during the 2 days of racing.
Well, if you needed reminding at all, the race days are in fact on Sunday and Monday, the 24th, 25th of August. 100,000 people are expected to be out for what will be the first ever road race on the streets of a British town or city. It's going to be exciting, and I'm looking forward to it.